and court. Craig Berube's Blues. It is Ryan O'Reilly against Leon Draisaitl, and away we go with the first period. And the Blues win the faceoff, tipped in by Buchnevich. Give and go with Barbashev, and it never got to Parayko, and swept away by the goaltender Koskinen. Now Bozak on it for the Blues. He wanders high. Thomas back out there. Blues on the power play. Tipped on goal by Barbashev. He scores! Ivan Barbashev!
Well, the original entry, as the linesmen take a look at it, and we'll see here, oh boy, oh boy. Right, you can see right here that Colton Parayko is clearly over the blue line. Now, the NHL does have the cameras that are directly above.
On further video review, it was determined the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal. Please reset the clock to 8:14.
Here's Perron quickly across Tarasenko to the other side, back to this side to Tarasenko to the net, tip, saved by Koskinen, and it's near the goal line, and it stays out. O'Reilly was right there, and Koskinen somehow kept it out.
Moves over to the right side, so very unpredictable, and this is a great power play setup, and a nice play by Saad, and then Saad, as he's falling backwards, tries to jam it in there, and Koskinen just gets the paddle of his stick on it, and then it rolls up, and it goes over the blocker of Koskinen here. Look at that right toe save on Saad, and this one here is a peach as well.
Against Draisaitl, Thomas wins it cleanly back for Parayko. Now Buchnevich gets it back from Thomas, across, one-timer, they score! Kyrou, what a pass, what a shot, and a power play goal!
Quick shot, quick release. Talking about Robert Thomas improvement on the dot. And you lose the faceoff, you got to spend 15 more seconds getting it back into the offensive zone, but instead it's a one faceoff and just a brilliant backhand pass. Wow, what a pass that is by Buchnevich. Boy, the two Russians, Barbashev and Buchnevich, headed it towards a dangerous area.
Now the Blues off the faceoff win by Joshua. He comes in there with Koskinen and Neal. And now James Neal grabs it. Back to Bortuzzo, a shot, rebound, Joshua is there, and it stays out. I don't believe that, neither does Joshua. What a save there by Koskinen.
In the backhand blade, but you can see the Blues do a good job here smothering Kyle Turris and the Edmonton Oilers. The rebound off the pad, the backhander's there, and a closer look after Robert Bortuzzo does an excellent job of getting it towards the net. Let's see.
And has 4 goals and 5 points in his last two. Long pass to center, intended for Saad. 10 to go in the period. Now CeCe down the wing. Here's Zach Hyman in front, and they score late in the period. It is McDavid with 0.8 seconds left.
David Perron goes down in the neutral zone, and he is irate at the official right there, but the Edmonton Oilers just bury their heads and go, and Zach Hyman ends up making the play from behind the net. I didn't originally see, let's see, there's the interference right in the middle of the ice. And Puljujärvi just knocks down David Perron. And so Perron thinks there should be a penalty, and well, there should be right there, at least an interference call. And there's Hyman going wide.
Now back to the line for Barry. Nugent Hopkins tipped in front. And maybe that pass intended across for Draisaitl never got there. And McDavid wanders out. Pass to Draisaitl, one-timer, he scores! Just like that, McDavid to Draisaitl, and it's 2-1.
Incredible pass by Connor McDavid as he wheels in towards the middle of the ice. He's on his forehand. Okay, that's not a very dangerous spot for him to be in. We'll keep our eye on 97 here. A quick dart to the middle. There, fake to the outside, right to the middle, and now you're thinking he's in good spot, except that he finds Leon Draisaitl, bottom of the faceoff dot, a very severe angle. Draisaitl is so good at that little one-time.
And Binnington around, now for Falk. For Tyler Bozak. Here he comes, drops it. Now for Perron. And a shot, partially fanned on. Perron is in there, and a mad scramble in front. Now back to Bortuzzo, he scores! Bortuzzo, and we are tied at 2.
for that puck to go to the net right here. Toe drag, fanned on, off the skates, in a myriad of different skates. What a play by Tyler Bozak. He dug it out from the pile right here, finds the open man, and yes, clearly the goal.
And that goes the same with Braden Schenn, who's out with an upper body injury, but the Blues would love to get some healthy bodies back, I know that.
Yeah, I would say the expectation is just that, and don't forget about Oscar Sundqvist as well.
Here's a pass in front, Nugent Hopkins, he scores! Under Binnington, and he gets his first of the year, and it's 3-2 Edmonton.
Neutral zone to get that puck into the offensive zone, and there the Blues have a chance to get that puck out of the zone. It gets intercepted at the blue line.
He had 16 goals last year in 52 games, so the Oilers go back on top at 3-2. That's kept in by Kyle Turris. Turris in front, wide open backhander, and they score! McLeod, I believe, into the top corner. It might be his first NHL goal.
It is. His first goal. He's had a strong game. It's only his sixth NHL game here this season. And this has turned around in a hurry.
2 goals in 8 seconds.
Now, the Blues guilty of turning pucks over, though. I mean, the first one was one that's got to get out of the zone.
And he'll toss it back to this side for Parayko. And here he comes. Now for Thomas. What's in front? Barbashev, and that goes high with a partially open net.
Oh, he can't believe it. He just can't believe it. Even though it was from a severe angle, he had the open net.
What a pass by Thomas.
Sky on this play, and you're right, what a brilliant pass by Robert Thomas. And Barbashev fires it. Well, you know what? I could see from his vantage point why he didn't think that went in. From that point of view, it did.
Bortuzzo wanders in.
Yeah, good hit there. Bortuzzo snuck into the offensive zone, and the puck was beyond him, but he makes a good hit.
And now Thomas a feet ahead, tipped by Bortuzzo. Dubuchkevich to the net, and that shot just wide by Tarasenko. Now Bortuzzo fans on it. Thomas, rebound, Dubuchkevich.
Get in there!
They score! Tarasenko, it does get in there! And the Blues have tied the game at 4.
Tell you what, Robert Bortuzzo made a couple of subtle little plays to keep it alive. It started out with a little momentum, getting that hit in the offensive zone. Bortuzzo has a goal in this game, but look at Tarasenko. He's not going to be denied. Bustavich looks like he's going to shoot it. It's a pass, fake shot pass. And
as Nurse waits for Yamamoto. And now on to Draisaitl, trying to go wide. And a good play by Rosen, centered. They score! Yamamoto with 27.8 to go. And another late goal against the Blues.
Incredible turn of events here late. This one even later. Entry into the zone. The Blues can't get that puck in deep. Draisaitl protects. And how does he find Yamamoto here with all the bodies that are there? He's in a prime scoring. Right-hand shot, puck's rolling, one times it.
And now O'Reilly for Perron. He's got to shoot it here. He does, it goes wide, and a disappointing ending again as the Oilers get the late goal by Yamamoto at 19:32, and they win 5-4.